गुड मॉर्निंग माई डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप यू ऑल आर फाइन एंड गुड एट होम. बी सेफ एवरी वन. स्टूडेंट्स, एज वी हैव ऑलरेडी डन सम ऑफ द वर्ड प्रॉब्लम्स, आई हैव ऑलरेडी टोल्ड हाउ टू फ्रेम द स्टेटमेंट. देन आफ्टर दैट वी हैव डन सिंप्लीफिकेशन वर्क. इन दैट आई हैव टोल्ड द रूल ऑफ बोर्ड मास, ओके, एंड आई हैव टोल्ड वट ऑल स्टैंड फॉर. एवरी थिंग वी हैव डिस्कस. Now today also we are here with some word problems only, but here in these the word problem which we are going to do today, that is the mixed word problems. Mixed word problem means here you will get addition, here you will get subtraction, division and multiplication too. Okay, here you will get everything. Okay, maybe in the question it is, the question will be framed like that, in which you have to add first or you have to multiply first, and then only you can divide and get the answer. So now we are going to do that all. Okay, just see. We will move on and we will see that what are the questions given. But before that, again, a little bit recap. Okay, I would like to give of the previous. Okay, a little bit summary, because this is the last exercise of this chapter which we are doing. After that, a division will be over. And then we are going to move on to the next chapter. So let's see. Terms of the division. Terms in division. What it is written? The number to be divided is called the dividend. We are knowing this. Any number when we are dividing, that number is called as the dividend. The number that divides another number, okay, or the number that divides the dividend is called the divisor. Next, the answer we get on dividing the number is called the question. About the remainder, it is not mentioned. I am telling you what is remainder. The leftover number, which is lesser than the divisor. This also keep in your mind. The leftover number, any number is leftover, it is not that remainder. Remainder should always be lesser than the divisor. Then only it will be considered as the remainder, my dear. Okay, so remainder is that number which is the leftover number and which is always lesser than the divisor. So that number will be considered as the remainder. Okay, like 20 divided by 4. Okay, when you will divide 20 by 4, what you will get as answer? You will get 5. So 20 is here dividend, 4 is here divisor, 5 is here quotient, and remainder is 0 because it is completely divisible. Because we are completely dividing this number. So 5 is here the question and remainder will be 0. Okay. We are here with mixed story sums. What it is written? Mixed operations story sum. Okay. We are going to discuss. I am going to discuss. Don't worry. Okay. Just see. See, in this question, what it is written? Weight of 316 bags of wheat is 30652 kgs. Find the weight of 147 bags of wheat. Okay, so what the question is saying in this, two kind of questions are there. In this, two kinds of questions are there. Weight of 316 bags, it is given. Weight of one bag. First, you have to find out the weight of one bag. So you will divide 30652 divided by 316. Okay, so you can see how I have done the division. Okay, I have written 30652 in the dividend column and 316 I have written in the divisor column. Then I have divided. Okay, then I have divided step by step. So first three numbers I have taken first, but it was not divisible. So the next number also I have taken, that is 5. Okay, so 3065 I have divided by 316. So in 9 times 2844 will come. So that 2844 we will write just below 30652 and we will subtract. When you will subtract, then you will get 221. Okay, when you will subtract, then you will get 221. Okay, now when you will divide it with 316, it is not divisible as 221 is lesser than 316. So what we will do in that case, we will take the third number down. We will take the next number down, that is 2. We will take the next number down, that is 2. Okay, this 2 we will take down as it was, this 3, these it was not divisible. So now it is 2212. Okay, 2212. So now that 2212 is divisible. Yes, it is divisible in how many times? In 7 times. It means 160 into this you will do, then you will get the same number. You will write 2212 just below 2212. You will write 7 in the question column. Okay, and then you will subtract. When you will subtract, you will get 0, 0, 0 at each and every place. Now, what is the weight of 1 kg of bag? Okay, it is 97 kg. Okay, it is 97 kg. Now, the next what it was written in the question, it was find the weight of 147 such bags. 1 kg, 1 bag weight we have already calculated, that is 97 kg. So, it is easier now. 147 we will multiply with 97, then we will get the answer. So, just see. You can see, my dear students, that how I have done. I have got by dividing, I have got 97 kgs that one bag carries. After that, I have to calculate that how many kgs of wheat for 147 bags will carry. So when I will multiply 97 is 1 kg bag weight, and 114 bags are there. We are already knowing. So number of bags are 114. Weight carrying each bag will be 97. Two statement will go in this. Okay. Then after we will multiply. When you will multiply these two, you will get the answer as 14259. Okay. Then you will multiply 9 into 7 when you will do. Okay. Then, sorry, not 9 into 7. 7 into 7 when you will do. Then 7 into 4. Then 7 into 1 you will do. You will get 1029. Then in the same way, when you will multiply 9 into 7, 9 into 4, 9 into 1, then again you will get 13203. Okay. 13230, not 203, 230. And then you are already knowing that after getting the two products, we have to add both the products to get the final product. So when you will add these two numbers, you will get 14259. And that is the total weight 147 bags carry. Okay, total weight of wheat 147 bags are 147 bags are carrying is 14259. Okay, few more examples I am having. In this question also, the same kind of question, a factory produces 128,4435 bulbs in 1 year. In one single year, how many days are in 1 year? 365 days. We don't used to take 366 as it is a leap year. If it is mentioned in leap year, then you can take 366. But if it is not mentioned, you have to take standard number of days in a year. That is 365. So 365 we will take. And then how many bulbs does it produce in the month of April? First we should know now that how many bulbs they are producing in 1 year, because this much total number of bulbs in 1 year they are producing. So how many they are producing in 1 day? When we will calculate how many they are producing in 1 day, then it will be easier for you to calculate how many they are producing in 1 month. So what you will write, bulb produced in 1 year, that is 365 you will write, 65 days. Then number of bulbs, okay, that you will write 1, 2, 8, 4, 4, 3, 5. You will divide both. Okay, when you will divide both, then you will get like this. Then you will get like this when I am dividing. So when I am dividing this number, my dear, you can see I have done the division work here. Okay, so I have divided 365 divided by 1, 2, 8, 4, 4, 3, 5. Okay, I am dividing 1, 2, 8, 4, 4, 3, 5 by 365. So when I am dividing, my dear, then I am getting as a question 3519. What I am getting as a question? 3519. Okay. So you can see. So you can see how I am doing. I have done the division, and when I have divided the total number of bulbs by 365, I have got 3,519 bulbs. Okay, means in 1 day they are producing 3,519 bulbs. How many? I am not showing you division work here because already so many times we have done the division. You are already knowing how to do. I am just telling you how to write the statement and how you can do this kind of mixed word problem. So you can see, we are dividing this number, then we are getting 3519, and that 3519 is the total production, is the production of 1 day. It is the production of 1 day. Okay, because the year production was given, the total year production was given, and we have finded out the production of one particular day. So what is the production of 1 day? Is 35 3519, ओके, एंड दैट 3519 इज द प्रोडक्शन ऑफ वन डे, बट वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट द प्रोडक्शन इन द मंथ ऑफ अप्रैल. सो फर्स्ट वी हैव टू नो दैट हाउ मेनी डेज आर देयर इन द मंथ ऑफ अप्रैल. सो अप्रैल इज हैविंग 30 डेज, अप्रैल इज ऑफ 30 डेज. हाउ मेनी डेज आर ऑफ अप्रैल? अप्रैल इज आर ऑफ 30 डेज. द मंथ ऑफ अप्रैल इज कैरिंग 30 डेज. सो दैट 3519 इंटू 30 वी विल डू. 3519 इंटू 30 वी विल डू. जस्ट सी नाउ यू ऑल कैन सी माई डियर एज इट इज बीन रिटन हेयर. ओके, वन डे कैलकुलेट नंबर ऑफ बल्ब प्रोड्यूस, नंबर ऑफ बल्ब प्रोड्यूस इन वन डे, दैट इज 3519 वी हैव कैलकुलेटेड. नंबर ऑफ डेज इन द मंथ ऑफ अप्रैल यू कैन राइट. ओके, और बल्ब प्रोड्यूस इन 30 डेज, 30 डेज मीन्स हियर अप्रैल ऑल्सो यू कैन राइट. बल्ब प्रोड्यूस इन मंथ ऑफ अप्रैल और नंबर ऑफ बल्ब प्रोड्यूस इन द मंथ ऑफ अप्रैल, दैट इज 30 यू कैन मैंशन. एंड देन यू विल मल्टीप्लाई 3519 इंटू 30. वेन यू आर मल्टीप्लाइंग माई डियर लाइक दिस, सो फर्स्ट नंबर इज जीरो. विद जीरो वेन यू आर मल्टीप्लाइंग एनी थिंग, देन जीरो विल ओनली कम. Keep this in your mind. Don't forget the rules of the multiplication. Then after, when you will multiply with 3, all the numbers, you will get 105570. Like this. After that, you have to add both. What do you have to do? You have to add both. Then 0 plus 0 will be 0. 0 plus 7 will be 7. 0 plus 5 will be 5. 0 plus 5 will be 5. 0 plus nothing will be 0. And 1 plus nothing will be 1. So, what is the total production? Okay, in 30... means in April, how many bulbs are produced? 105570. This is the total number of bulbs produced in the month of April. The number of bulbs produced in the month of April is 105570. One more question I am here with. Just see. Arun sold 287 mobile phones for rupees 7659 each. Means each mobile phone he sold on this amount. Okay, and how many sold? 287. From this money he bought 369 watches. Whatever the money he earned by selling all the number of mobile phones, he earned whatever amount. Okay, he bought 369 watches from there. Find the cost of each watch. But for finding the cost of each watch, we have to find the first total cost of total mobile watch which he has earned. So what you will do, you will write number of mobile sold, that is 287, then you will write cost of each mobile, that is 759. It is given here, you can see it is given here. These two statements we will write. After writing these two statements, my dear, I will multiply. What I will do, I will multiply. Okay, so when I will multiply these two, you can see, when I will multiply 287 into 7659, okay, what we will get? Just see. Then after, when we are multiplying here, my dear, we are multiplying here, these two numbers we are multiplying. So you can see we are multiplying here. So 7 into all the numbers we have done, then we have got this as answer. Then 8 into all we have done, then we have got this as answer. Then 2 into all we have done, then we have got this as answer. Okay, and don't forget to write 0. Okay, like 7 into all we are doing, then we are getting this number. Then when we are multiplying with 8, then first we will write 0 at the ones place, then only we will write the product. Okay, in the same way, when we are multiplying with 2, then we are putting 2 zeros at the first two places. Okay, and then we are writing the product. After getting all the three products one by one, we will add all the three products. Then you will get 2198133. That is the total product which we have got when we have multiplied 287 into 7659. Okay, this is the total product. So Arun used rupees this much to buy 369 watches. 369 watches. What amount of money he used? He used this amount of money. The answer which you have got now here. This is the total amount of money which he has spent in buying the 369 watches. Now you can calculate the cost of one watch by dividing this total amount from 369. So let's do it. Just see, students. Okay, total we have already calculated the total number of amount which he earned on selling the total number of mobiles. Okay, total number of amount earned in selling the total mobile phones. Okay, नाउ वी हैव टू डू वॉट, नाउ वी हैव टू कैलकुलेट वॉट माई डियर, नाउ वी हैव टू कैलकुलेट दैट वॉट अमाउंट ऑफ मनी ही स्पेंड, वॉट अमाउंट ऑफ मनी ही स्पेंड ऑन बाइंग दी 369 वॉचेज एंड वॉट इज द कॉस्ट ऑफ टोटल मीन्स वॉट अमाउंट दैट इज ऑलरेडी वी हैव गॉट बाई बाई मल्टीप्लाइंग. ओके नाउ वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट दैट वॉट अमाउंट ऑफ मनी he spent in buying the one watch. So when you will divide 369 okay by 2198133, you will get the product, you will get, sorry, you will get the question as 5957, and that is only that 5957 is the cost of one watch. Okay, and how we have done the division you are already knowing. I don't think that I have to explain this, how we have done the division, my dear. Just see how we have done, like 369 is there na, so first three digit we have taken, but that digit is smaller than that, so the fourth digit also I have taken. Now I have divided that, so in five times it is being divided, and then I have subtracted here, and then I have got this as answer. Now 353 is again not divisible, so the number this we have take, I have taken from upside. So now it is a four digit number and it is not divisible in 9 times. So 9 I have written upside, and then I have subtracted these two. Then I have got 210. Now again 210 is lesser than 369. So again it is not divisible. So the next number which is written at the dividend column, that we will take down, that is 3. So now it is a four digit number, 2103. So now we can divide it by reading the table in 5 times. Okay, in 5 times it will be divided. Now that 1845 we will write just below 3103, and we will divide. When you will divide these two, you will get answer as 25. Okay, but rest all two you will get 00. 25 is not divisible. Okay, 25 is not at all divisible. Now what we will do, we will take the next number down. Okay, we have got 258, not 25. We have got 258, and 258 is not divisible. So for that, we have taken the last number down. So now it is 2583. Now it is divisible completely by 7 times. When we are reading the table of this 7 times, so we are getting, so we will get 2583. You can divide. Okay, you can multiply. You can read and you can multiply here. You will get the same thing. So, this is completely divisible. So, we have got the cost of one watch, that is 5957. So, this kind of questions only you are going to get, my dear student. This kind of questions only. Means multiplication and division will go together. Okay, the multiplication division will go together. One more question I am going to discuss, in that you will get addition. Just now you can see, my dear, in this question it is addition. What the question is, a farmer produced this much red apples and this much green apples. He mixed these apples and packed them in this much boxes. How many apples did he pack in 40 packed in a box of 40 apples remain unpacked? How many he packed that 40 are unremained, means 40s are not packed. So first the total number of apple you calculate. So how we will calculate the total number of apple, just see. Number of red apples you will write, just see. Number of red apples produced, number of green apple produced, both you will add first. When you will add first, you will get the total of number of apple which is being produced. Then you will get the total number of apple which is being produced by the farmer. Then after that, unpacked apple is 40. Apple packed, the total packed apple we have already calculated. There is a twisted question, it is, my dear. Don't get confused. Okay, total number of apples we have already calculated. Okay, number of unpacked apple now we can find out now, because total apple we are, suppose we have suppose any kind of any chocolate box is there. In that chocolate box I have packed two munch and two five stars. Okay, two munch and two five stars. Okay, and one chocolate was unpacked, that is Dairy Milk. Okay, so 2 plus 2 when I have done, then total number of chocolates I have got, that is 4 chocolate, and one chocolate was unpacked na. So from that total, okay, Because all we are calculating about the chocolate. It is not being distributed that number of red or number of green. No, we are totally calculating. So number of chocolates there are four, and one was unpacked. That is the dairy milk was unpacked. So that dairy milk we will subtract from the total number of park and five star which we have calculated. That is four. So we will get three. So what is the left means? What is the total number of chocolate we are having? That is three. In the same way, total number of apples, red and green, both we have added, and we have got the total number of apple. From that total of number of apple, we will subtract the unpacked apple. We will subtract the unpacked apple. When you will subtract the unpacked apple, then you will get, previously it was 6, it is 6334402. It is. When you have subtracted 40 from it, then you have got 633402. Okay, number of boxes of packing, number of total boxes of packing are 462. So now we are having total number of apples with us, and number of boxes also we are knowing. Now we can calculate easily that how many apples are packed in each boxes. Just see, you will divide here. What you will do, you will divide here. You can see total number of apples we have already calculated. We have subtracted the unpacked apple also. The number of boxes are also given. Apple packed in one box. You have to calculate one means how many apples are packed in one box. So you will divide this two first. Okay. Means 633402. You will divide 462. Okay. Just divide it. You can see we are dividing this number. Okay, this is the total number of apples. From that total number of apples, we are dividing the number of boxes of apple which we are having. When you will do the division like this, my dear, you can see the division I have already performed. I have already done the division here. Then you will get the number of apples in one box. Then you will get the number of apples in one box. So how you will do the division? Again, I am telling, it is a 3-digit number, so the first 3 digit only you will take. That is 633. So when you will read the table of 642 one time, then you will get the same. When you will go to two times, you will get more. You will get more. Okay, that you can do it also. You will get this, okay? 2,924 you will get, and it is greater than 633. So you cannot do take this. You have to divide it by 462. Okay, so you will write 462 just below that. When you will subtract, okay, you will get 171 as remainder. Now, is this number is divisible by 462? No, it is not. So we will take the next number down, that is 4. So you will take 4 down, then it will be 1714. Okay, 1 you have written at the question, because in one time you have done the division. After that, when you will subtract these two, na, when you will read the table of this, means 462, 3 times, how many times? 3 times, then you will get 1386. You write 1386 just below 1714. Okay, then you will get 328. You will get 328. So that 328 you will write, and then the next number which is written here, that is 0, that you will take down. Okay, because 328 is not divisible by 462 as it is lesser number. So that number which is written at the dividend column, that we will take down, that is 0. So it will become 3280. Now it is a 4-digit number. So when you will read the table of 462 7 times, then it is divisible. Okay, 3234 you will get. So now you can divide this, because if more than that you will go, then the number will increase. Okay, if it's 8 times you will go, so the number which you will get, that will be more than 3280. So not with 8 times, with 7 time only. So we will write 3234 just below 3280. We will subtract, we will get 46 here. What you will get? 46. Now the last number, that is 2, you will take down. Okay, now it will become 462, and in the divisor column also it is given 462. So it is completely divisible. Okay, so now you will get as remainder as 0, and the question you will get as 1317, and that 1317 is only the number of apples packed in one box. 13 means 1371 apples are packed in one box after remaining the 40 un packed apples also. Okay, there are means 1371 apples equally packed in all the boxes, and 40 are 3 mein. That 40 we have already subtracted in the beginning. Now the student, this question here I am with, this kind of question is given in your book. The question is, find the greatest 7 digit number which is exactly divisible by this. Find the greatest 7, you don't have to find, you are knowing this, the greatest 7 digit number. Which is the greatest 7 digit number? Greatest 7 digit number is 9999999. This is the greatest 7 digit number. You have to divide it by 834. And when we will divide it by 834, we will get the answer as 11990. What you will get as answer? 11990. Okay. So, you can divide and you can see that you are getting the same or not. I am not dividing here. This I am leaving for you. Okay. After this. Okay. Exactly. That we have done. So what is the question we have got? 11990 we have got as question. So now there when we have done the division, my dear student. The division was completely not over because the remainder was left. The remainder was 339. Okay. But in the question it is written exactly number you have to find out which is divisible by 834. Okay. So what you will do now. The question, the number that is 7 digit number, from that you subtract the remainder. What you will do? Here we are subtracting, my dear. You subtract the remainder. When you will subtract the remainder, then you will get 9999660. And that is only the exact number which is divisible by 8340. Okay. When you will divide, you just see, when you will divide this number with this number, okay, then you will not going to get any remainder. The remainder will come as 0. It means it is completely divisible. That only it is asking, exactly divisible. But previously when you are dividing, okay, previously when you were dividing, then we were getting the remainder as 339, okay, and it is not being asked that any remainder should be left. It is only asking that what number exactly will be divided from this number, then the answer this number will be completely divisible. So with the number, this number, this is the number with which we will divide, then we will get. So here remainder you will write, divisible number that you will write, and then you will subtract here. Okay, then you will get the exact number. Then you can write therefore exactly exact number which is divisible by 834 is 9999660. Okay. Now the last question I am with, my dear students. What is the question? 98 rupees and 46 paises are equally distributed among the 6 people. Okay. What is the total amount distributed? This much is in rupee and this much is in paise. And in how many amount distributed in 6 people? How much money amount does each person is getting? What you will do? Amount each person is getting is 98 rupees and 46 paise divided by this. So you will write first the question, amount equals to 98 rupees and 46 paise, number of person 6, then you will divide. Okay, when you will divide, the first step is to divide. Okay, when you will divide now, then you will get 2 as remainder and 6 as the question. Okay, but you have to find the exact number of amount which each person is getting. So that 2, whatever you have got as remainder, okay, that remainder you have to convert in paise. Okay, then that remainder you have to convert in paise so that you can find it out the what is the total amount each person is getting. So just see in the next step, my dear, you can see in the next step, my dear, you can see what it is written. Just see what it is written. Just see, convert the rupee. It is written, convert the rupee obtained in the remainder to the paise and then add to the paise. Okay, means paise and rupee was given, but we have already divided the rupee. We have not divided the paise. You have seen here, I have already divided the rupee. 98 rupee only I have divided. Paise I have left. I have not divided the paise. First I have divided the rupee, and when I have divided the rupee, I have got 16 as the question and 2 as the remainder. Then that 2 remainder I will convert in paise. So how I will convert? 1 rupee, 1 paise, 1 1 rupee equals to 100 paise. 1 rupee equals to 100 paise. So when I have divided that 98 rupees, I have got 2 rupees left. So that 2 into 100 when I will do, then I will get the amount in paise. Because 1 rupee if equals to 100 paise, then 2 rupees will equals to 200 paise. So 2 into 100 you will do, then you will get 200. And 200 प्लस 46 यू विल डू. व्हाई? बिकॉज 200 इज ऑल्सो इन पैसे एंड 46 इज ऑल्सो इन पैसे. सो टोटल पैसे यू विल गेट दैट इज 246. नाउ दैट 246 यू डिवाइड बाई 6 बिकॉज नंबर ऑफ पर्सन आर नॉट चेंजिंग. नंबर ऑफ पर्सन आर नॉट चेंजिंग. जस्ट इट वॉज गिवेन इन वी हैव जस्ट calculated one by one. One first we have calculated a rupee column, then we have calculated the paise column. When we have calculated a rupee column, we have got 16 as the question and 2 as the remainder. Then that 2 I have converted into paise, and that both the paises I have added together. Now I will divide that paise between the 6 people. Now you can see when I have divided, then I have got the answer as 41. Okay, 6 into 2 is not possible. So 0 is written at the first place and 2 will be taken down. Now 4 will be taken down. Okay, and it will become 24. 24 will come in the table of 6 in 4 times. You can read the table. Okay, in 4 times you will get 24. 24 you will write just below 24 and then you will subtract. Then you will get 0. Okay, 4 minus 4 will be 0 and 2 minus 2 will be also 0. Last number is left, that is 6. Okay, so 6 you will take down, and now 6 minus 6 will be 0. Okay, 6 minus 6 is also 0. So 41 you will get as the question, and now no remainder is left. So what is the exact amount? What is the amount? Okay, each person is getting. So you will write in the last, write the two question from the step 1 and 3. The first question you have find out, the second question you have find out. Now you have to write both the question. First question is 16, second question is 41. Both the question you will write. So you will get 16 is in rupee and 41 is in paise. Okay, so 16 rupees and 41 paise. Each person get 16 rupees and 41 paise. This is the exact amount each person is getting. Total amount was 98 rupees and 46 paise, and how much each person, how many persons were there? 6 persons. So one time we have divided with the rupee and one time we have divided with the paise, then we have got the exact amount that each person is getting. What is the exact amount each person is getting? Each person is getting 16 rupees and 41 paise. Clear? So this kind of question can also come. Okay, it is little bit tricky because here conversion also we have done. We have converted also. So maybe this kind of question also can come. That is all, my dear students, for today. And I hope you all have understood how to do the mixed addition, word problem. Okay, because related with the multiplication, addition and plus subtraction, all one by one I have discussed. How to write the statement, that also I have discussed. So students, go through the video. Watch it nicely and just see how you have to do. Don't get confused because this is the first time you are doing the mixed questions of word problems. Okay, previously one time addition, subtraction separately you are getting, but now you are getting all together. So you have to calm down and then you have to read the question nicely and you have to understand that what operations we have to perform in it. Okay, that is all. If still you will face problem, I am there for you. You can come in the online class and you can ask. That is all, my dear. Thank you, everyone.